Good morning, dear students. Today in this video we are going to discuss about the nature of roots. We all have studied already the chapter quadratic equations. You know that it is of the form ax square plus bx plus c equals 0, right? And today we are just going to see how in this equation, finding out the discriminant, when we find out the discriminant, how can we decide the nature of the roots? You know that the quadratic equation will have two roots, right? The degree is 2, so you have two roots. So what will be the nature of the roots? How can we decide? So that can be decided by finding out the discriminant. Now what is the discriminant? Discriminant is given by the formula d equals b square minus 4ac. The value of d decides what nature will be of the roots. We'll start with the first option. When the value of d is greater than 0, if you get a value of d greater than 0, a number greater than 0, then we can say that the roots are real and distinct. You are going to get two different roots and the roots will be real. Similarly, if you calculate d is equal to 0, then we get roots as real and equal. You will have real roots, but the two roots will be repeated. You will have the equal roots, right? Now, and if in case you are getting d less than 0, that is some negative number, in that case roots will not be real, okay? You will not get real roots. So let us solve 2-3 problems based on this concept to more clarify it. So I have selected one previous year question, 2014. Find the value of p for which quadratic equation 4x square plus px plus 3 is equal to 0 has equal roots, right? So children, we have to compare this equation with this quadratic equation in general form, and when I compare this, I get the value of a. You can compare, value of a will be 4, value of b is p here, value of b is p, and value of c, when we compare, we get it as 3, right? Now I mixed it. We have given that the equation has equal roots, right? The equation has equal roots. So what is the condition for getting equal roots? That d should be equal to 0, right? So for equal roots, we know that d is equal to 0. What does it mean? What is the value of d? D means b square, which implies b square minus 4ac should be equal to 0. Now we'll substitute the values. What is b square? So b square means p square, which implies p square minus 4 from the formula a. What is the value of a? 4a and c. What is the value of c? 3. And this should be equal to 0 because d is equal to 0. Right? So what I will get? I will get as p square minus 4 4s are 16 and 16 3s are, we can say, 48. So p square minus 48 is equal to 0, or we can get as p square is equal to 48, or we can write p is equal to 48 will become, when you will take the square root of that, it will become, see, already it is being factorized, right? So it will be 4 outside the root and under root of 3, and children, you have to write that because it is square. So we will get two values, that is 1 plus and 1 minus. So p will have the values of plus minus 4 root 3, plus minus 4 root 3. Now let us see one more question based on that. Find the nature of the roots of quadratic equation. So you need to find the nature. What do you mean by nature? You have to find whether the roots will be real, equal, or they are not real. So how can we decide that? We can decide that by finding the value of d, which is equal to b squared minus 4ac, right? So first we need to compare, which is the value of a, which is the value value of B and which is the value of C. So when I compare it, I get as A is equal to, you can say A is 13 root 3, B is 10 and C is root 2. Children, in this equation there is no negative sign. If there is a negative sign, you have to consider that also, right? Now, next I am going to find, because I have to find, I have to decide the nature of root, so I will find the value of B, that is B square minus 4AC. So what is the value of B? We can write B is equal to B square minus 4AC. So that is equal to, what is the value of B here? So B is 10. So 10 square minus 4 into, what is the value of A? A is 13 root 3 into C. What is the value of C here? C is root 3. C is root 3. So we can calculate this. So when we calculate this, 10 square will be 100 minus. Now this root 3 and root 3 will give you 3, and 13 into 3 multiplied by 4. So 39 into 4 will give you 156. So this will be 156, and you can see that you are getting minus 56. So value of B is minus 56. So what conclusion can you draw from this? We can draw the conclusion that because here the value of B is negative, it is less than 0, hence the roots are not real. Therefore, we can say the roots are not real. Now let us solve one more problem based on that concept only. So I have selected one question, previous equation. If the equation, that is quadratic equation, 1 plus m square x square plus 2mcx plus c square minus a square is equal to 0 has equal roots, prove that c square is equal to this, we need to prove it. Okay. Now what is the first step? It is given that they have equal roots, means I am going to use the condition d is equal to 0. D is what? D is b square minus 4ac. So first thing, I want to find out what is the value of a, b, c, and for that I will be comparing the equation with the given quadratic equation, right? So if I compare, I get the coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is a, so coefficient of x square will be 1 plus m square. Next, coefficient of x. So coefficient of x is 2, is that will be the value of b, and that will be 2mc. Do not write x, the coefficient of x we are writing. Next, c, the value of c, that is the constant term, and that is given as c square minus a square. That is given as c square minus a square. Now children, next, what are we going to do? We are just going to find out d. So we know that d is equal to b square minus 4ac. So that is equal to b square, means the square of this term. So when you will do the square of this term, so this will be 4, 2 square 4, m square, c square, right? And 4 m square, c square, and this is c square, next minus 4ac. So 4 from the formula, 4 from the formula, and a, what is a value? 1 plus m square. What is the value of c? 4ac, the value of c is c square minus a square, and that should be equal to 0. Why? Because we know that it is given that equation has real roots, correct? No, sorry, equation has equal, real and equal roots. Next, we'll solve it. So this will become 4m square c square. I am not changing. Or we can do one more thing this side. I can divide 2 out by 4. So we will just leave out this 4. Divide the equation throughout 4. Then we will left with m square c square minus. This 4 will also be not there next time. So this, when you will multiply these two brackets. So when I multiply these two brackets, let me see what I get. When I multiply 1 with these two terms, I get as it is c square minus c square. Then n square multiplied by c square will give me plus n square c square. Then n square square multiplied by minus a square will give me m square a square, and that is equal to 0. Next step, we'll see if anything gets cancelled. So m square c square, now I'll open the bracket, so this will be minus c square minus n minus will plus a square minus n plus, so minus n plus will be minus m square c square minus n minus plus m square a square is equal to 0. Now children, I can see m square c square and minus m square c square is getting cancelled. Right. Now I have to focus what I need to prove. So it is there, it is actually a square and a square m square. Right. That has to be proved. So I will collect the terms like that. So first term is, say this thing is c square. So I can see one c square is here. Right. Then I need a square and a square m square. I can see a square and a square m square here. So the thing is done. Just you have to rearrange it. Okay. So if I do it, I am just transferring that c square that side. So that will become positive c square. And here I can take a square common. When I take a square common, then what will be in the bracket? In the bracket it will be 1 plus m square. Right. So a square 1 plus n square is equal to c square is you have to prove, and hence it is proved. So this type of questions also can be based on this concept, that is nature of